Sir, it is a great privilege and honor to speak on this very important bill subject, which has been pinching this country for the last many years. And we hats off to the Home Minister, Honorable Home Minister, and the Prime Minister for their vision. And this will completely solve the problem of Kashmir. Sir, the courageous and bold and daring step of the Honorable Home Minister will be remembered in the Indian parliamentary history forever, sir. Sir, our party president, Sri Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, and our party wholeheartedly supports the move of the Honorable Home Minister and the Prime Minister of the country. Sir, I have few questions to be asked to the principal opposition of Congress party in this August House. Sir, had Nehru not been recalled, the Indian Army, which has gone 25 kilometers inside the Pakistan and overpowered the Pakistan Army, we would not have been discussing this issue, sir. Secondly, had the Jawaharlal Nehru entrusted the job to the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, who was icon of unification of India, we would not have been discussing this issue, sir. Sir, had the Jawaharlal Nehru not succumbed to the dictates of the then Pakistan, then Kashmir ruler, and paved way for the Article 370, we would not have been discussing this issue. Sir, had the provision in the Constitution, which is temporary in nature, the Congress party should have dispensed with, which they have not done it. So in that case, we would not have been discussing this issue. Sir, I have a few points to be brought to the notice of the Parliament, sir. Sir, as two swords cannot be incorporated in a shell, how can we have two entities within the Union of India? Sir, how can this country have two constitutions? Point number one. Point number two, how a state can have two separate flags? Point number three, where, just show me on this earth where a national flag is burnt or torn off, and such act does not constitute the crime. It happens only in Jammu and Kashmir. Sir, another point. Sir, how can a Pakistani become a citizen of India by simply marrying a Kashmiri girl? Sir, how can Kashmiri girl becomes untouchable and loses all the rights and her children rights if she marries a boy from other parts of India? Sir, how can a boy can retain the rights and privileges even if he marries a girl from other parts of the country? And is it a gender justification or blatant gender discrimination? Sir, I have one more point to be brought to the notice of this, sir. The people of this country have been fighting since 1947 to realize their dream of looking India as one entity, one India, one union, and one nation, which is possible only because of the present Home Minister, Sri Amit Bhai Shah, sir. And the proposed move of the Honorable Home Minister, I am very happy that Honorable Home Minister is fulfilling the task that has been left out by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, sir. Albeit, due to the blunder of the Congress party, I am reiterating, to the blunders of the Congress party and the Jawaharlal Nehru, is applauded by 130 crore people of India, of this country, because of the objective is to achieve Sabka Vikas. Sir, the last few points, sir. This move will definitely strengthen the sovereignty of the country. This move will remove the discrimination between the citizens of India. The move paves way to remove the subclause 3 of Article 370, which is absolutely temporary in nature. Sir, this move will bring peace and tranquility in Jammu and Kashmir. This move will help develop Jammu and Kashmir along with the other states and increase the socio-economic conditions of the people, sir. With these submissions, I once again reiterate our full-fledged support to the vision of the Home Minister and Government of India. Once again, congratulate the Honorable PM and Home Minister for taking this bold and courageous step. Thank you very much.